Department of Electronics from Walchand Institute, Solapur. Today in this lecture, I am going to discuss with you a very important concept of paging in the operating system. Now in this video lecture, we are having these objectives. That is, at the end of this video, you are able to describe the concept of paging. Then we are able to describe the various benefits and drawbacks of the paging. Now in this, the goals are, we will understand what is the memory management, then what is the meaning of external fragmentation, then the paging mechanism and the paging table concept. As we all know here, during process execution, we use the memory. Now, normally the program is stored in the logical memory, or I can say hard disk, or so called as a secondary memory, that is prefetched by the operating system and is brought into the main memory. And the CPU is going to access the data from the main memory for execution. But whenever the CPU starts execution, he generates the logical address, and this logical address always points the data inside the physical memory or in the secondary memory, I can say. So we are going to prefetch the data from this secondary memory and is brought into the main memory. Now MMU is nothing but the memory management unit. It helps us to bring the data from the secondary memory to the main memory by converting the logical address into the physical address. This one more thing is to be understood is that the virtual address is always in the secondary memory. It always starts with the base as 0, and the MME is going to bring the data from the secondary memory back into the main memory. The figure shows you that concept here. The MME is going to address the memory as well as the IO devices, and the address which we used to point out these two devices is normally called physical address. As I said here, whenever the CPU is going to select a process for execution, it generates a virtual address. Now this address is always pointing towards the secondary memory, because CPU always get data for execution from the main memory, which means that we have to bring the data from secondary memory into the main memory in the advance. It is normally called as a prefetching. So MMU is going to convert the data, that is of virtual address type, into the physical address which is pointing the main memory. That is normally a case of RAM in our case. Now what is the paging here? Now paging is a memory management scheme by which the computer stores and retrieves data from secondary memory into the main. So paging, naturally in the paging, we normally divide the secondary memory into equal slots here. That is, we are going to deal the secondary memory in parts. It is normally called the partition. The partition, two types of partitions. The first is called equal sized partition, and second is the unequal sized partition. But normally we use the fixed partition or fixed sized partition in the paging scheme. So we divide this entire secondary memory into small blocks. Now each block is normally called as a page, or I can say here, I will divide this entire secondary memory in different pages. Now the program that we stored in the secondary memory, that is now covering number of pages in the given secondary memory. Example, a program can cover 15 pages in the given secondary memory. Similarly, the memory manager divides the physical memory, that is the RAM, into again equal sized pieces, that is called the frame. Normally the size of frame is always equal to the size of the page. But remember that the size of physical memory, or I can say the size of main memory, is always less than the size of secondary memory, which means that we never going to bring all the contents in the secondary memory into the main memory. Or I can say reversely, only interested part from the secondary memory is brought into the main memory. Now this diagram shows you that concept here. I said that there is secondary memory. We are having one program, so example program 1, it is covering page number 0, 1, 2 and so on. Now we are trying to prefetch data, so this MMU is come in the picture. He will convert different addresses in different required forms here, so that we can bring the data on page number 0, page number 1, page number 2 into the physical memory. Now in this diagram, the logical address space, the secondary memory, is having a program that covers page number 0, 1 and 2. Whereas in the physical memory, in the RAM, it has got different frames numbered as frame 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now in the physical memory, the frame number 1 is already occupied by some previous data in the computer or in the operating system. So the frame 0 is open, frame 2 is empty and frame 3 is empty here. Now this MMU is going to take utmost care this frame of where to put this page in the moment. Now as I said here, the data is prefetched by the operating system. So in diagram, as I said here, data is brought from the secondary memory and is brought into the physical memory. Now as you see here, there are two options here. These pages can be stored in the main memory, either in the continuation, it is normally called as a contiguous memory allocation, or these pages can be stored in different locations in the main memory. This is normally called as a non-contiguous memory allocation. So in this paging, we can store all these pages, that is from the secondary memory, into the main memory, either sequentially or in non-sequential fashion. It is normally called contiguous allocation or non-contiguous allocation in the given main memory. For example, I can take this example here. Suppose I got program 1, is suppose covering 15 pages in the secondary memory. So as we all know, these 15 pages are first brought in the main memory. They are stored in different locations which are called as suppose the frame. Suppose currently the CPU is executing the frame number 1, and suppose suddenly he wants the instruction which is present on the 14 number page. Now in this case, the CPU is forced to read the page number 1, then he will go to page number 2, he will go to the page number 4, and after all this reading first 13 pages here, he will get himself on the 14 number page here, and where he is going to find the required instruction for execution. Now these kind of difficulties are reducing the speed of access here, or reducing the speed of processing. So to overcome this difficulty here, the operating system manages one more table. It is normally called as a page table. Now what is page table here? Page table is a table in which it has got two columns. First, he carries the page number, and second, he carries the frame number. Page table is a data structure. It is not the hardware. It is normally maintained in the main memory. So the table shows that page number 1 is stored in the frame number 1. Page number 2 is stored in. Now again, just revise the problem here. Suppose example, the CPU want to execute some instruction, suppose on the page number 2. So it generates the logical address. It normally has got two components here. One is called the P2, that is the page number. And second is the offset, which is D in my case. Now this page number will load this or indicate the page number 2. So in this page table, we are going to take a control on the page number 2. And we know in the table, it shows that the page number 2 is stored in the frame number 1. Which means that the data of required quality or required quantity is found on the page frame number 1. So that I am going to convert this logical address as now, not as P2, but as F1. And we know here, I want the instruction which is at the dth location in the given page number 2. And we know here, the size of page and the size of frame, they are equal. So I can find the required instruction in the frame number 1 at dth location. And this collective information is going to point the main memory that points the page number 2, that is the frame number 1, and in which I am going to find out my required instruction. Now in this way, we are going to find the paging here. Now you see that in this case the pages are stored in different locations, so that there is not a case of any external fragmentation case here. Secondly, we take the help of the page table. Now page table is stored in the main memory, is indicated by a register, is normally called as a page table based register. Now what are the advantages of this paging here? In the paging, we can store the pages in non-contiguous fashion in the main memory, so we never get external fragmentation there. Then as the data is in the main memory, the access time is always less and we are having the faster process execution here. And now what are the drawbacks of this paging here? As we know here, before we start reading the frames data here, we first refer the paging table here. So that always kept in the main memory here. So CPU has to first read the paging table here, and then he will read the required frame which contains the required data. Which means that the CPU has to read this main memory twice to execute a processor. And hence, the time required to execute a process is get increased here, or the speed is get lower down here. And secondly, the internal fragmentation problem is not completely resolved here, because some page may not be covering all the frame here, so in which some of the space in the frame will remains empty here. So this problem is not at all resolved here, but is normally ignored here because that is not so much disturbing in the processing here. Now these are my references here. Friends, I expect that you understand the concept of paging here. Thank you much.